Before ending this lesson, I want to talk about a couple of practical considerations of particle filters. And the first one involves sampling. As you can imagine, sampling is really important, okay? Because I have this set of samples, and every step I have to generate a new set of samples. So I have to resample it. I go grab a sample where the probability of pulling out that sample for state X is proportional to the weight of that sample. And typically, I'm doing this a constant amount of time, so n times. So I'm using 1,000 samples, 10,000, however many samples, I'm doing that every time. We'll talk, actually not today, but next time. That number can get kind of big if your state space gets large, so being able to sample effectively or efficiently or less often is kind of important. So I want to talk about resampling a little bit. What we have here is an outer ring, okay, where the idea is that the arc length of that ring is proportional to the weight. Okay, so, you know, W1 is small, W2 is bigger, W3 is huge, et cetera, whatever. And these are all the weights, right? So you can think of sampling as following. I just randomly pick a direction, and if I hit W3, I'm going to take sample number 3. So that'd be my first sample. All right, do it again. If I hit WN, I pull out the nth sample. And basically, I have to keep doing that n times, right? So it's like a roulette wheel. I spin the roulette wheel n times, and I have to figure out where I land. And that figuring out is actually a binary search, so that's log n, but I do that n times. So it's an n log n operation. So that's kind of, it's not awful, but it doesn't scale linearly with the number of samples you use. It goes up by n log n. It turns out there's a cute little trick that you can use that is, instead of like a roulette wheel, is more like a wagon wheel. And the way it works is this. So let's suppose I have n samples. I can make a set of spokes that are 1 over n full rotation around. So here I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? So each one is an eighth of an arc. And what I can do is I can randomly put it down someplace. And if I've randomly done it, then I can just read off for each one of these spokes which W did it hit, okay? And in fact, the starting weight, right, I can just start at some random one here, and I see what W am I at, and I go to the next one, and I see, did I pass a boundary? If so, then I'm at the next W, and likewise. So what's nice about that is that's done in constant n time, and it's sometimes called stochastic universal sampling, systematic resampling. The nice thing about it is that it's a linear time complexity. You know, if you do 10,000 points, it takes you so long. If you do 20,000 points, it takes you just twice as long. All right, and it's very easy to implement. In fact, it's so easy to implement, let me show it to you.